Hello, and welcome back to Let's Play The Outer Worlds Murder on Eridanos DLC. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. See, my gun is, injured. It's this gun. Right. Which one am I using, actually? Ah, I did it again. Okay. So this place looks like a building, but apparently it's to the Caves of Zeal? Or abandoned Rizzo's bunker? Oh, this one's damaged as well. Okay. Now this... Which one is the reload? Not that one. You know why? What's the other game I'm playing? My reload is the key I kept hitting by mistake and taking the inhaler thing. Cyberpunk. Cyberpunk 2077, that's what it is. I finished playing that, but I'm just so used to that being the reload key. Jeez, what are all these candles? I guess there's no electricity.
Using the promise of transcendence to lure profit seekers. Shameful.
I think so. Penitent disciple. Not a friend?
For Lord's sake! Put that away!
Not attacking. Okay. I'm not gonna listen to him. Prophet Disciple Daily Schedule. 5 o'clock. Awaken. Not just wake up. Awaken. 5 o'clock to 12 o'clock, praise the prophet, listen to the prophet. 12 to 2, sweat house meditation. 2 to 2.02, lunch. That's a quick lunch. 2.02 to 4, hot cold training. 4 to 5, stomach purging. 5 to 5.02, dinner. 5.02 to 6, stomach purging. 6 to 8, medical attention. Well, I wonder why that would be. 8 to 10, clean the retreat. 10 to 12. Right, so this person sleeps 3 hours a day. Right, because they awaken, I'm guessing, is 5 in the morning. And that's their afternoon. Hot coals. Eating, purging. 10 to 12, beatings by prophet. 12 to 1201, free time. Woohoo. 1201 to 2, disciples' choice, self-flagellation or meditation on productivity, followed by no food next day. Well, at least it's self-flagellation. It'd be worse if someone else did it, right? You wouldn't know exactly when it was coming. 2 o'clock, sleep. What a life. There's a door we can open. Bench. Aaliyah Mason. So I thought you were going to attack us.
I'm going to absolutely murder the next quarterly report.
You do that. Stealing stuff. Hello?
It's not good enough to be better than everyone. I need to believe I'm better than everyone.
Okay.
The Prophet's treatments are intense. I nearly collapsed during the last session.
Oh, there he goes. Okay.
The Prophet of Profitability has changed my life. Her seminars are worth every bit.
Okay. Guess at least a semi-friendly place. Emphasis on the word semi.
By concentrating on profit, I can invite wealth into my life.
Invite wealth and walk on hot coals.
By imagining wealth, I can evoke prosperity out of the universe.
Alright, I'm gonna talk to these people, but first, I got a couple. Weapons to repair here. And some armor, apparently. Alright, we gotta read that, but let's see what's going on over here.
The Prophet's treatments are intense. I nearly collapsed during the last session.
It's not good enough to be better than everyone. I need to believe I'm better than everyone.
Hi.
By concentrating on profit, I can invite wealth into my life.
Okay. Oh, there's the Prophet of Profitability. Alright, so who's this other person then? Hi.
Hello! Welcome to the Prophet of Profitability's Private Prosperity Retreat.
My.
Stay positive, and soon all your humors will be balanced.
Okay.
At least, that's what I keep telling myself. Anyway, I'm Aaliyah Mason. I work as the Prophet's right-hand woman. What can I do for you?
Well, can you tell me about the retreat?
If you felt imbalanced and unproductive, linger in your malaise no longer. We have all the amenities and practices for calming the ill humors strangling your potential. Sit for hours in our sweat house and sweat them out. Or stand amidst burning coals and feel your productive inhibitions burn away.
As well as your toes.
And remember, think positive. Positivity equals productivity equals profitability.
What would you guys do without the letter P? Do you know the Prophet well?
Of course. I've been studying under her for years. I know each of her techniques more or less by heart, and even have some variations of my own, such as the quintuple daily stomach purges.
Good for
you. She's promised me that I'd be allowed to open my own branch of the retreat someday soon. Of course, I've been waiting on someday soon for coming up on 4 years now. I'm sure it's gonna happen anytime now.
Yeah, you know, it's someday soon. For a positivity disciple, you sound a little less than enthused.
Oh, terribly sorry if I gave you that impression. I had a cramp. It's better now. I mean, it might be nice if I had a little inclination of whether the Prophet appreciated all the cooking and cleaning and hours of meditation I do on a daily basis. But whatever she thinks isn't for me to question. I'll do my best to be more chipper.
I don't care if you're chipper or not, just making an observation. I was hired to look into Halcyon Helen's murder. gonna have to ask you a few questions.
Oh my. Yes, this is important enough for me to delay my bi-hourly self-flagellation. Ask away.
Anything should be that important. That's kind of cutting right to the chase, huh? Have you noticed any unusual behavior in the retreat lately?
Well, by and large, no. But something rather odd did happen regarding the Prophet recently. A few hours after our high-profile visitor arrived a couple of days ago, the Prophet asked me to take over sessions for the remainder of the day. At first, I was excited. Thought it was my chance to show her what I could do in charge. But then I saw that she was deeply worried about something. No one saw her until the next day.
Where were you at the time of the murder?
I was here, at the retreat, in the company of the other disciples and clients. I rarely have more than a few minutes of alone time. Which is fine, of course. I do what I do in the service of the Prophet. Who will, I'm sure, reward me for my sacrifice? Eventually.
The Prophet had some kind of feud with Halcyon and Helen, right?
Yes, the circumstances there are quite unfortunate. For a time, the Prophet was completely despondent. Even the hot coal walks weren't buoying her spirits as they usually do. However, we recently had a high-profile visitor whose presence seemed to alleviate whatever the Prophet's fears were.
Who was it?
I'm actually not entirely certain. It was a surreptitious visit that stood out because it was surreptitious. Whoever it was must have paid the Prophet quite a lot to keep things quiet. At least that's the only reason I can think of for intentionally keeping things so hush-hush.
All right, that's all for now.
Certainly. Actually, before you go, I want to report something suspicious.
Oh?
I noticed the Prophet dragging something, a bundle, away from the retreat after that high-profile guest arrived. Normally I'm the one who does her laundry, so it was strange.
Huh.
Especially because whatever she was dragging seemed oddly human-shaped.
You sure it was a body?
I think so. Had the right size and shape.
Couldn't you have brought this information forward a little bit earlier?
I could have, but I generally don't have the time or energy to leave the reserve to contact anyone. Plus, there's always the possibility that I'm mistaken. The Prophet hasn't been herself lately. But if I misinterpreted the situation and reported her improperly, I'd ruin my chances for opening my own wing of the retreat.
Well, maybe you just did that. I'll look into it. What do you think, Max? Curiouser and curiouser, huh?
Timeline discrepancy detected nearby.
What's she doing with the honor guard's headwear? Well, before she tells me to get the hell out.
Analysis suggests this to be a variety of herbs. Herbs have been uniformly treated with a pungent chemical mix. Warning. Ingesting, smoking, or inserting non-corporation sanctioned substances into your ears may be harmful to your health.
Burning these would generate some pretty toxic smoke.
Side effects from extended exposure include dizziness, nausea, and unconsciousness. Additional likelihood of organ shutdown and or death.
Can you analyze the chemical these herbs are treated with?
Analyzing complete. Substance appears to be a mix of industrial solvents and various essential oils. Substances include woolly cow dander remover, sprat oil, and starship surface wax.
Huh. How would these most likely be used? To burn it, right?
Prior analysis suggests these herbs reach peak effectiveness when users burn them and inhale the resulting smoke. Whether or not this increased effectiveness is good for an afflicted individual has yet to be determined.
Do I dare? Though the dry herbs are difficult to chew, the flavor is less bitter than you would have expected. It's woodsy, like tropical, with a singed aftertaste. It's actually slightly better tasting than your average can of salt tuna, though so are most boots.
Hypothesizing potential side effects from herb consumption. Most likely outcome, decapitation. Slight possibility of calculation error.
Jeez. Well, I just consumed it. Is my head gonna get chopped off? Hooray for pressing the correct button. Did I read that? You know a way to tell? Yeah, I've read it. Chapter 1 continued? It was chapter 1. CD bar, yeah, I read it. So, that's empty. There's this, and then there's the helmet. Why the random helmet? Greetings.
Fruitful and productive welcome, sister. I had a feeling you would visit me. I offer a wide variety of productivity seminars. I hope you'll consider taking one. Ah, but I should remember my manners. To what do I owe the pleasure of the special inspector's arrival?
How'd you know I was an inspector?
My disciples come to and from the Grand Colonial, bringing supplies and information. Knowing what happens at the hotel affects my livelihood, after all. With that said, I'd love to involve you in one of my productivity seminars. We should clear you of all those nasty, nasty humors hampering your potential.
That's funny. I know what she means by humors, but what I generally think of as humors is, you know, comedic in nature. Yeah, let's have her. Yeah, humors. I don't think I understand. Let's have her explain this.
As science has taught us, the body is made up of two things, flesh and humors. These humors are semi-fluids that, when improperly balanced, may cause you to function inadequately. By signing up for my seminars, you can balance these humors for only mildly inordinate and repeat payments. Cancellation is subject to repercussions.
What kind of repercussions?
Nothing you need concern yourself with, sister. It's all in the contracts. But of course, no one need subject themselves to such repercussions if they don't cancel. Regardless, can I interest you in a seminar?
So this is how you get your profitability. Just to humor her. You know, I have a feeling like my potential is hampered lately. What do you offer?
We offer a wide variety of seminars for all your corporate needs. Employees not working hard enough? Employees dying too often? It's most likely your managerial humors. And of course, seminars for balancing the energies of your business offices. Interior decorating is much more important for success than many would believe. If any of this sounds at all interesting to you, might I interest you in the first 82 words of our most popular seminar's introduction? Free of charge.
Free? Sure, I'll hear it.
Byzantines live lives fraught with competition, and that competition can be immensely stressful. You must, first of all, find a way to balance your thinking. Think not of bits lost, but of those you have yet to gain. After all, peace leads to productivity, and productivity leads to profit. Though thought alone won't balance you. We have a strict regimen to promote humor clearing. Session attendees stand on burning coals, sit for hours in our productivity smokehouse, and of course, fast throughout.
So in order to be productive, I need to suffer?
Precisely. The barriers within yourself will break down as your skin sweats and blisters, giving the evil humors the proper space to escape. It's my patented method.
So there's evil humors too. Well, you've got some interesting herbs in here.
I'm pleased that you noticed. Excellent eye, sister.
That's a little gun I have.
The compound they're treated with is my own invention, designed to unlock an individual's true productive potential when burned. I can't say any more. Trade secrets, you know.
Well, they seem toxic. Toxic enough to potentially kill someone.
None of my clients have ever complained, so I'm sure they're perfectly safe.
They're dead.
Is there anything else?
I followed your trail the way you dumped something in the wilderness.
Oh, really? What did you find there? What did I dump?
I think it was your morals.
Very funny. But not implicative. Anyone could have made that path. And even if it was me, you don't know what happened. I'm delighted to extend my desire to aid you, sister. How might I assist?
Someone said they saw you dragging a human-shaped lump into your yurt.
Who said that? I'll be sure to give them a special seminar on not needlessly implicating the person who puts food on their table. It was a bundle of clothing, sister. Even productivity geniuses need to do laundry from time to time.
Yet the herbs I found in here hint at all of these. The herbs I found in here hint at a visitor. What are you hiding?
I don't know why you seem to suggest I don't get others here, sister. Customers are my lifeblood. I had a visitor, yes. But as it turned out, some of my productivity techniques were too much for them. I had to drag them out by hand. But their peers came and collected them shortly thereafter. I'm sure whichever attendee it was is perfectly safe now.
Safely dead. Well, I'm going to ask you some questions about Halcyon Helen. Please answer truthfully.
Oh? I'm surprised. I wouldn't think the two of us would have much to discuss about her. We may have had some terse interactions before her death, which I most certainly regret. But beyond those, well, never mind.
No.
What would you care to know?
I always mind. No, never mind. Did you contact Helen after you left the Grand Colonial?
I did not. She had no interest in my seminars, and I had no interest in attempting to convert a stubborn actress. Why would I have had any cause to engage with her further?
Where were you at the time of Helen's murder?
Why, I've been at the Wilderness Exploitation Reserve for quite some time now, as my disciples can attest. In fact, I haven't visited the Colonial since I arrived several weeks ago. Bad energies, you understand.
Well, you and Helen didn't get along, I hear.
I wouldn't necessarily say that. The media tends to exaggerate. I will admit that her remarks about my seminars were rather unfortunate. However, I certainly wouldn't sharpen any sabers over it, if that's what you mean to imply. I only do that when my clients skimp on their bills.
Remind me to never be your client. Let's talk about something else.
I hope you now realize that I had nothing to do with Helen's demise.
I realize nothing. Okay. All right. What's it say? It's red stuff, yeah. The red stuff. So is her little thing still going on? Alright. You've learned that Helen disparaged the Prophet of Profitability's work seminars, harming her image and costing her bits. Investigate whether or not this would have motivated the Prophet to kill Helen. I discovered the body dump site, but no body. Whoever was here seems to have gotten up and walked away. Search to retreat for evidence that proves or disproves the Prophet's alibi. She claims she only met Helen once during her altercation, their altercation at the Grand Colonial. She says she hasn't left the Wilderness Exploitation Reserve since she arrived there. The Prophet was witnessed leaving the retreat, dragging what appeared to be a body. You discovered herbs inside the Prophet's tent that have unpleasant side effects when they're burned. Okay. Oh, I gotta look at that. Hold on a second. Let me check up on what I'm doing. I didn't read this. This. Prophet of Profitability Private Meditation Terminal. Welcome. If you're in search of a seminar, please speak to the Prophet of Profitability directly. The messages on this terminal are private. Should you read them, your humors may be thrown off balance. Is your curiosity worth the loss of profits? Yes. From Ruth Bellamy. Prophet, I've talked with my agents and they've told me that what I said about your seminars, re not taking them, actually lost you about 30% of your revenue for the next 3 months, with future losses projected. When I said I wasn't much interested in attending, I didn't really realize that I'd hit you quite as hard as it did. Guess that's the price of stardom. Everyone listens a little extra to everything you said. I'm hoping, if you've got space, that I might be able to attend one of your sessions today as a means of apologizing. I know that notice is short, but I'm hoping you can fit me in without too much inconvenience. Ruth Bellamy. From Lee Whitaker. Hey, Prophet. Whitaker here. Wanted to ask how that mix of herbs I sent you has worked out. I was skeptical at first about using them for meditation purposes, but hell, what do I know about productivity? That said, be sure to remember what I told you. Don't cut the herbs asymmetrically. Hampers the texture. Don't leave them out in the sun, and for law's sake, make sure you keep the smoke doses small. Last thing you want is to accidentally send somebody into a coma, or worse, kill them. Be smart, Whitaker. From your devoted attendees. Prophet, the other attendees of tripling product profits through transcendentalism. Right? I got that right. And I have reconvened, and we're all in agreement. Your seminars are simply top-notch. We've seen a 0.5% increase in each of our businesses and total profits since we attended your seminar together. Of course, with the price of materials, shipping, and other costs involved, it boils down to more of a 0.1% increase, but an increase is an increase. If you ever decide to visit the Grand Colonial, you simply must let us purchase you a round of drinks. Thanks to you, we certainly have the bits for it. Well, they must have a lot of money if they can notice a 0.1% increase. I mean, think about 1% of $1 billion is still a lot of money. Excuse me. So something popped up here. You've uncovered enough inconsistencies in the Prophet's alibi that's apparent that she's hiding something. Time to confront her. Well, I want to explore this place first. I'll confront her after that. Otherwise, you know all these people are going to come after us, and it's going to be a war zone. Come on, guys. Yeah, look around in here.
Nice and easy.
Mm-hmm. Oh, there's another? Hold on. Project End Notice. Notice to all employees working in the Holy Caves. We regret to inform you that this atmospheric complex now belongs to Sublight Underground. Under the terms of our new inter-corporate agreement, all Rizzo's employees remaining on the complex will be viewed as corporate spies by Sublight Underground. While you remain here, you will not be under Rizzo's protection, nor will you be paid for any continued work. Please report to Rizzo's property for processing. Failure to comply will result in termination, either by Sublight Underground or by Rizzo's fixers. Please refrain from misusing company resources to continue to survive. Thank you. Survival, huh? Who needs survival, right? Not too much to see here, actually, other than that notice and a couple things. So this is... I don't know if this was... This is for employees working in the caves. I don't know if this pertains to the cult or of profitability or whatever this is. Hi.
The Prophet's treatments are intense. I nearly collapsed during the last session.
Mm-hmm. Hmm. Alright, well, we're gonna finish exploring this place next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.